we're here. We'll have a quick look inside. So, Commander Station. Gunner Station. Breech blocks underneath here. It's the length of my arm, you can see how big it is. And we've got storage around here. Is it like the, I don't know if these are the test version or the practice version. That's also his sabot round. More of them up here, more above there, above the turret ring, which is just above there, but non-explosive elements. And then we've got more storage bins, which are either for Herschel combustible case charges, which is below the turret ring. Again, another sabot round, more storage, another main storage bin, big box there. You can hear the engine through the back. Absolutely love this thing. So whilst we're here, let's have a quick look at the other bits that's on it. This is Commander's Propeller. Little press gates you can see out of. Mount the machine gun if needed. This is the loader's hatch for what they now call the operator. Couple of looks at some of the bits you'll see for the Mark 10. For the Mark 11. So the Mark 10, there's an added all this beast armour along the top here, steel brew. Gunner sight just there. And then for the Mark 11 is when they introduced TOGS. So this is the actual physical TOGS sight. Open.
Nice to see it back here.
Protective patch, and that sets in this unit here, and then the cooling unit, because the thermal sights get bloody hot, is this unit here. So when you're looking at later Mark Chieftains, if you see the steelbar in the front, it's a Mark 10, and then if you see TOGS, it's a Mark 11. As I said, you can see the vents there for the cooling unit. So that's it, Chieftain Mark 11.